the first thing I want you to ask yourself, anytime you are entering into a friendship or anything, that what am I going to give and what am I going to receive? Some people are in your life not because they love you, it's because of what they receive. Hello? Some people are hearing at you today. Some people are praising you, celebrating you today, not because they are so much in love with you, but because you feed them in one way or the other. So they must pretend as if they love you. When you take that thing out, you have taken the love out. They said, let's go and search for a man who can help you in this situation. That anytime that evil thing will come and he begins to play, something will happen. Give me another verse. And Saul said unto his servant, provide me now a man that can play well and bring him to me. Let's go. They answered one of the servants. Then answered one of the servants and said, behold, I have seen a son of Jesse, Bethlehem, that is cunning in war, playing, and a mighty valiant man, and a man of war, and prudent in matters, and a dear, comely person, and the Lord is with him. Let's go. Wherefore, Saul sent. What we are reading, I want you to underline something to me, because there was a time that Saul was asking who David was, and I was very shocked. Somebody who sent messengers to go to Jesse's house and even wrote a letter to Jesse was the same man who was asking in some quotation, in some verses, that who is the son of this man? Who is the father of this man? Send me David, thy son. This is the letter from Saul. Send me David what? Thy son, which is with the sheep. Let's go. And Jesse took an ass with bread and a bottle of wine and a kid and sent them by David, his son. Amen. His son unto Saul. Let's go. And David came to Saul and stood before him, and he loved him quickly. And that's all Donica can pull. The love was so great. The love was so powerful. The love was so extraordinary. And he even became his what? Armor bearer. Do you know who armor bearer is? He became his what? Armor bearer. Put your hands together for Saul. He's such a wonderful person. He's such a wonderful person. Let's go. See. Verse 21. David went, and Saul went to Jesse, saying, let David, I pray thee, stand before me, for he has found favor in my sight. The first time he said, I love him. Second time he said, the guy has found favor in my sight. So I don't even want him to come to your house again. I want to stay with him. Now the question is, the love and the favor, was it a rare thing or it was benefit? Give me the last verse. Let's read together. And it came to pass, when the evil spirit from God was upon Saul, that David took an harp and played with his hand. So Saul was refreshed and was well, and the evil spirit departed from him. Put your hands together for the Lord. Oh, I can't hear you. And say, Father, help me to know those who are not happy with me, who are not happy with me. Put your hands together for the Lord. Let's read another scripture. 1 Samuel chapter 17. Verse number 54, 1 Samuel 17, verse 54. Now, it read, help me with this TV, it's going off. It read, and David took the Philistine head and brought it into Jerusalem, but he put his armor on his tent. 55. And Saul saw David, watch this show, and Saul saw David go forth against the Philistine, and he said unto Abner, the captain of the host, Abner, whose son is this young? This youth. Now this is my problem. The scripture we just read right now, the Bible says that Saul wrote a letter and sent a messenger to Jesse's house that I need your son David. But right now, he is asking, whose son is this? The things are changing. The jealousy is stepping in. Amen. And Abner also said, as thy soul liveth, oh my king, I cannot tell. Let's move on. And the king said, and how thy whose son is what? Stripling. Verse 57. Let's go. Mm-hmm. Read it. Mm-hmm. Saul of the Philistine in his hand. Last verse. And Saul said unto him, whose son art thou young man? And David answered, I am the son of thy servant Jesse the Bethlehem. The last chapter we are reading, chapter 18, verse number 6, 1 Samuel 18, 6. That's where I'm landing the quotations. 1 Samuel 18, 6. And it came to pass, as they came, when David was returning from slaughter of the Philistine, that the woman came out of all the city of Israel, singing and dancing to meet the king's Saul. With what? Tablet, with joy, and with instrument of what? Music. Uh-huh. And the woman answered one another as they played and said, Saul has slain his thousands, and David has done what? Slain 10,000. And Saul was very angry, and the saying displeased him. And he said, they have ascribed unto David 10,000, and to me they have ascribed but 1,000, and what can he have more but the kingdom? And the Bible says from that very day he started hating David. Listen to me. We are dealing with friends' goat, right? There are some people, they always want to see you saying thank you and yes and master. David was a servant in the house. David served in the house. And Saul was having no problem with David. David was just a commoner. And Saul was having no problem with David. He was celebrating David to the point of giving David his own daughter. But the Bible says that jealousy stepped in because of the success of David. Am I talking to somebody? There are some people you will never know they hate you, but just hit a breakthrough. That is when you will know that they are not happy with you. Come on, am I talking to somebody? There are some people you think they love you so much because in the time of misery and in time of difficulties, they are always there. They cry with you, and at times they even extend their hand to help you. So you think that they have good intention concerning your life. They are people that they are happy to see you in the same level. They are people that they don't want you to be in the same level with them, because they always want to be the one helping you out of every situation. But when God begins to bless your life, that is when it exposes this kind of people. Somebody is not talking to you, not because you have done anything, but your crime is that God is blessing you. Somebody is so angry with you, not because
because you have insulted them, but because God has changed your situation, God is turning your life around, and they are not happy for that. May God punish the devil.
Look at somebody and tell them they are not happy. Not because you have done anything. Your crime is you are good and you have become a perfect person. There are some people they want to. Saul, look, listen to me. David stayed in the palace with Saul and working as a servant. And this man is angry because people are praising him. Do you know there are some friends, they got angry anytime people talk good about you. There are some friends, they got angry anytime people would tell them, oh, this woman, this sister, this man is very good. There, I know some men of God who doesn't even want it to hear that somebody prophesied on them. They always want to receive the praise to themselves. Immediately people will begin to talk about you, you turn up to become their enemy. But listen to me, nothing will stop God from enlarging your coast. Nothing will stop God from blessing your life. Nothing will stop God from giving you what you deserve in 2020, in 2021. I pray and I prophesy over your life that may your grace be so great to the extent of exposing the friend's goat in your life. There are some people who come to you and pretend as if they are so powerful, and your suffering cannot bring them out, but your success will bring them out. Somebody is not feeling comfortable, not because of anything, but your success is making them feel uncomfortable. I pray for you and I release a prophetic word upon your life that if I be a man of God from this very day till the day that the Lord will appear, let the Lord of hosts give you something that will expose your enemies, something that will bring them forth, a success that will bring them forth. Shall I receive it? Shall I believe? I pray for you that those who are not happy with you, they can go to hell, because whatever the Lord has said will surely come to pass. I remember David in his own trouble said to Saul that you want to kill me, not because I have been disobedient, not because I have done anything, but you want to kill me because of the glory of God upon my life. But I declare that I shall not die, but I will live and declare the works of the Lord. There are things that you need to declare, and that is the works of the Lord. And the works of the Lord are the good marriage he's given to you, the better blessings he's given to you, the better life he's given to you. God is not yet done with you. God is not yet done with you. Receive grace to prosper. Receive honor to prosper in the name of Jesus. My God, we are not happy, not because you have done anything. We are not happy because of your success. At times, let your success take the revenge for you. Am I with you? In their mind, they never thought that you will have yourself a good man. They always wanted you to cry and feel so heartbroken. Some of you, when it comes to disappointment and heartbreaking, if we have to vote, your friends will vote for you. Because at least between you and them, they have tried and managed to talk to you not at least four heartbreaking. But get yourself a good man. The same people who were talking to you, advising you that don't worry, God will bring a good man. The good man will come according to their prophecy and they will be jealous. Friends of good. Good friends. There are people they always come around with. Do you know there are some people, if we see you within the next 1 minute, we will see a friend come. You move together. You drink together. You eat banquet together. You be no we grab them. Check a crown or the peace now. Say a professor or kaka crown or the akanam. You do things together. I dare money that they be a dresser. And you cram more bram to me. You do everything. But I'm telling you that in their heart, they don't wish to see you going where they are not. You know, do you know that some people, they always want to be ahead. They don't want to see anybody standing and having even a competition with them. So immediately, even if you are your friend and they see you achieving something good, they go out. You call them and they won't pick it again. Stop disturbing yourself. At times your success, at times there are some people you don't have to tell them yourself that they should leave. Your success must drive them out from your life. Are you with me? Your success. One day God told somewhere that I don't have any deal with Saul. So stop mourning for that guy. I don't know him. We are done. Now my favorite is David. Anoint that guy for me. God has disconnected himself from Saul, but David was still trying to connect it. Anything God has disconnected, if you try to connect it, it will come and disturb you. If somebody is leaving, don't force them to come. Hello. The reason why at times most of the girls who have double heartbreaking is you always go for your ex. Wako. And he is coming. This time, what is he coming to do? The harm will be greater than any other thing. The heartbreak that it will come in double force. Are you with me? There is a saying that Sankofa Yenchi, right? They can't go for class. They can't go for Omwami. Sankofa Yenchi. Go back is there. So for Sankofa Yenchi, you can't say. Okay, so let me put it this way. What's it? Taking back is not.
Go take back is not dislike.
Go take back is not dislike. Okay, let me put it this way. Going back to something is not evil. Okay, that was a saying. Let me put it that way. They might have an English word for it, but let me put it this way. That going back to something is not an evil thing. Okay, the prodigal son went back to his father. It was not an evil thing. But trust me, there are some people, don't allow them to come back. They are not coming back to do anything. They are coming to finish what they started. Somebody will be there, and all of a sudden, without you doing anything to that person, all of a sudden the person will decide not to pick your call, not to talk to you, not to do anything with you again. You are forcing it, pushing it. The person says, oh, nothing. Oh, when you're busy, and you are pushing it. They are afraid of your success. Something is driving them out. Don't bring them. You don't know why they are going. No, be on the life. And there was a little misunderstanding and Nipan Koi. They were not talking. They were not talking as if they were enemies. No. But I used to come to your place, but this time I will not come. When you call me, I will answer. How are you? We greet ourselves. That is it. Okay. Now, one way or the other, he started reassociating himself with the same person, and the harm, the hurt he went through can never be compared to the first one he did to him. There are some people, they can change, but they cannot change from jealousy. It has become a spirit, and until they repent for God to deliver them, they will still remain in that position. And it just takes a little time for them to reveal themselves to you again. So if your success push them away, don't bring them back. They are coming to pray. Are you ready to pray? It's not everyone who says God bless you meant it from their heart. Some people are saying it as a formality, but they don't mean it. Stop associating with yourself with people whose agenda is to bring you down. At times, you don't need God to open your eye to tell you that Marvin is an evil person. You just have to pay attention to the sign of the person and how they behave. Do you know that some people, when you call them and tell them a good news, 1 week they won't call you? Do you know that? There are some people, when you call them and tell them a good news about yourself, that same week just try and sit down where they would never call you, because they are hungry. They are angry, they are hurt. And jealousy is something that when it's taking over your life, you won't even notice it. You won't even notice it. That's why you can get a pastor who is jealous. You can get a bishop who is jealous. A prophet who is jealous. And if a prophet who say that say yes, the Lord is a prophet, then a church member who say amen. I don't know if you're getting my point. The prophet who said, "That saith the Lord," or you church member, all you say is, if that saith the Lord is jealous, then amen will be rich. Stop believing people. Your problem has nothing to do with your family people. Your problem with your mouth. You talk too much. You share things to anyone you meet in this life. That is why your enemies are more. Some of you have to live a private life. You always tell people that you live a private life, but you don't live a private life. You are a public figure. You mean public figure? You are a public figure. Everything. There are some people, if they scan as Santa, there are some people when they are eating, they will bring it on social media. At times when they are cooking, you are chat. No, they are between the status or so. Obi bring to me coach, obi a dear neck. And no, 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 deal. Obi a dear neck, no, they are better. No, actually. I'm enjoying myself. You are bringing on unwanted enemies, unwanted jealousy over your life, just because you are also living a fake life. Some things 2021, stop doing it. Hello? Now, who did you have to wire there? You know that. You are telling the person, say, now we'll be man or one man. If you swear now, they will hate you for no reason. Have a private life. Do you know one thing I have studied in this life? That there are some people who are rich, but nobody knows, because they live a very private life. And you know, sir, take this from you, can take it or leave it. Those who are poor, those are people who show off. Those who are poor, they don't have anything. Onyade a wallpaper, yet nidan said than a four square. Who said a dine air form? Say, aha, ha, ha, ha. For Onya, the wallpaper, and the tire on one side. Yahoo! Oh, make us out there. Now wiping any pimples. Now a brighten official any, but that's why your enemies are always following your life. Stop exposing yourself. Luke chapter 1, verse 80. Give it to me. I'm done. Luke chapter 1, verse 80. Now let's read together. And the child did what? Grew and waxed strong in the spirit, and did what? Live in the desert till the day of his showing unto Israel. At times you have to live in the desert. You have to live at your corner until one day you don't have any option because your success is bringing you out. Some people, they didn't come out themselves. Their success brought them out. Amen. And the child grew and waxed strong in the spirit and was in the desert, a private place, a secret place where no eye can see whatever he is doing, until the day of his achievement he was shown to the public. Stop showing yourself. Some of you, you say things before the thing will even happen. Obi oha onye appointment our embassy say American embassy and I say hefa nana for 40 crowns and an so what o chalo mama appointment to next week na make interview I saw call ya wakoji. Keep things to yourself. I'm a pastor and I will never teach you wrong thing. I remember some days I used to travel without telling anybody. I'll go main country, the animal call. Me quite my friend, my good. And one day I was traveling to Germany and I said it at church that these days you are growing, so me, I'm traveling. I will go today. I went to the airport and for almost 1.5 hours they were detaining me that the passport is not mine. It was not the first time I met Tukayo. That was my third time of going to Germany. Third time. With the same passport. They said it's not for you. And me was also, my said James B. And my said Tom James B. I want to buy. I'm saying, no, there. You won't go. I'm saying, okay, sign, signature, my sign. I'm saying, signature, yes, yeah. Almost 1.5 hours and I could hear my name mentioning Stephen Essel, Stephen Essel, because my own for your mother now say time or so my almost one mama. One day pa me ko cry house of life before Kosiko. And I don't know, so I don't know what happened. I just looked at the man and I gave the man my return ticket. He said, can I have a pen? Also, they had the name of Metradi. One of Metro address, I'm a quiet meeting. And one telephone number, I'm a demand, I'm a suit, I'm a baby. Or China program, they start to work with preaching. One of my family back, I say, I'm not a wolf. When you're before a head, my name is Rosina Mediatico. The man said, we are doing our work. You know, these days, blah, 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 and all the passport in the man. So I'm so wow. Obi ame. I feel myself go through a while. Now you pay free inside. The first go for the criminal police. The rest are back home busing. Me and some crime about you are no DJ criminal police. This time I know so 30 minutes. I'm the touch because you share me too. I'm seeing you say, no, the groves are sending themselves off from Numitu. Bram, me, bray. Ewa, Brabom. And I'm seeing, I'm going to get to me, what is happening? Oh, no, why you call me a chapter? No, I say, and that time I was using people. When you say, be grab, me, the face, I crack it, me, grab paper. But I don't trust you. You see, your problem is you, because you sell your stuff too much. A guy proposed to you, and instead of you praying, not the opportunity status. That's why some of you are still singing. Ochira omo e na e ne no mo tan ka be chire. Wo de omo e beto ona bubu bubu my bubu. Ena de omo e Ivan, what can I say? My boo, my babes, not the abeto, not the love emoji at all. Live emoji, I'm going to blue ni green now. Or the red, green, blue, or so I trust a BBBO only. Not the ababeto, anyone there? Boy, no way. Also, to be post to you. Why, yeah! Can we pray? Any friend who is in our life pretending to be there with us, but in other words trying to block our success, may God take